Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Bonsai Talk. If you are curious about maintenance and bonsai care in summer, I suggest that you go back and watch our old video about it, because we will go in depth about this subject and we will talk about how to treat a tree during summer.
People think that watering is a pretty straightforward thing to do.
These come in different shapes and sizes.
Fruit and flowering in a tree can also be a victim of pests and diseases.
This episode will focus more on just showing some of the trees in progression. 2019 summer. Okay? Good. Now, let's talk about the first tree. This is a Scots pine, a Yamadori Scots pine. And it was collected, I think, 3 or 4 years ago. I am not sure anymore, actually. Maybe 4 years ago. Originally, it was very bland and very boring. All of the features were missing on a Bujingi style like this. So we had to wire it to make it somehow a bonsai tree interesting. So every single branch has been wired on this tree. I think twice, actually, when I think about it. And as I recall it, this branch here was very weak, like only two buds and two flushes of growth in the tip here. But lo and behold, it managed to recover and now it's actually sprouting everywhere. So this branch here, I've not touched that branch this year. I've just let it grow without any restrictions. Just grow, because I want this branch to be more in proportion with the rest of the tree. Because it's really not that now. So that's something we have to strive for and work for in the future of this tree. If you look closer to the tree, you will see that the pads are not defined. They are not as full and dense as they can be. So with time, we will get denser pads. We will establish those pads, and that's when I think the tree will really shine. Also, the needle length is pretty long right now, and that will eventually get shorter with more ramification, of course. And what you're seeing right now is actually the needles from 2 years ago, or maybe 1 year ago. I think it can be both, actually. The reason why these needles still is on the tree is because this year's growth haven't really come off and hardened yet, so we can't pluck those needles yet. We have to wait for this growth to, you know, elongate and harden. Then we can take them off. Also, they serve a purpose as a backbudding motor, you know, for the tree, because the Scots pine will backbud on old needles. It will also backbud on brown wood, but it will backbud on old needles. So it has two ways to serve as a purpose. In time, I think we have a pretty cool bonsai. So, you know, I thought about tree number two and I thought, well, why should I always pick up the best trees and the most ramified trees and, you know, the most show-worthy trees, the quality bonsai, if you so will. No, I'm not gonna do that today. I'm gonna show you some projects and I'm gonna show you some of my smaller trees as well. Because that's also bonsai, and I think that it's not fair to only show quality specimens all the time, because you can't really learn anything about the process when you're always talking about old refined trees. So what I'm gonna give you or present for you here is another project that I've had, which I haven't really talked anything about on the show. This is a Mugo pine. A little garden center tree that I bought, I think, 3 years ago. And the tree has this year actually died back on two branches right here. Which is unfortunate, of course, but that is the name of the game. That's bonsai, ladies and gentlemen. What's good about this tree is that it has all the ground structure wired and ready. I don't have to do anything about that. I just have to continue develop denseness and pads on this section right here. And I think that this autumn I will try to gin these two to make it, you know, to make those features and make more interest out of the tree itself, because right now it's looking very sick, you know, but that's pines, you know, that's conifers right there. Conifers is all about dead and alive all the time. That's what we like with conifers. We want to see that contrast. So back to the health of the tree. I mean, it's very healthy, and Mungo pines, they do take a pretty long time before you get that needle length, especially when you have a small project like this one. But eventually I will get there. It will take time, and some of the tree's needles that you are watching right now, they are actually from 2 years ago. Because Mungos, unlike other pines, they do not backbud on brown old wood. Scots pine do, and Japanese black pine do, but not Mungo pines. So, a nice little cool project for the future. Funny enough, I just thought about larches, and I don't believe we really touched upon that subject here on Bonsai Talk. And I think I've just shown you pictures of the larches that we have collected over the years. So I guess this is a really good contribution to this episode, because we really need to talk about larch more. And yeah, here we have one. This is a Yamadori larch, which we collected 2 years ago. And you can see this specimen when we collected in one of our Yamadori videos. It's been growing 2 years now in the same original soil. We haven't changed anything. And I think that has given the tree a lot of roots. Hopefully it's just packed with roots here. So that I'm looking forward to work with that on next spring. Originally the tree had a lot of barred branches, and then I selected this front right here. Unfortunately, a lot of good flaring with the roots are down here on the other side, on the opposite side of the front, but you know, maybe we can work something else out, I don't know. What's really cool about larches, European larch, is that the branches are very flexible. Even a thick branch like this, you can move around easily. And that has to do with the cell walls, because they are filled with water. And they are very thin compared to other conifer species. So there are no problems at all styling a larch. You can see for yourself, they are very flexible. And I'm going to demonstrate here how to pinch a shoot. Let's say this shoot, for example, now when we are in the active growth season. When this shoot starts to grow out and elongate like this, you just pinch the tip. Like that, and that's it. And then they fork and they divide into two and so on, and you get ramification and you get dense tree. So that's how the larch works. Here we have another shoot. We can pinch that as well. Now we'll just take the soft tip like this, and I will just pull. Like that, done. This is a very pleasant species to work with when it comes to bonsai. They are very easy and beautiful trees, I think. Although this is a very scruffy and rugged looking tree, with time we can make something beautiful out of this. I am pretty sure about that. One subject that we really haven't touched upon when it comes to bonsai summer care is how to deal with weeds. Now, weeds are really terrible for bonsai trees, especially when it comes to trees planted in the same growth season, like this material. This is a birch that was collected this year, and as you can see, the weeds are taking over the pot. They are suffocating the roots for the bonsai and completely stealing all the water and nutrients. This must be eliminated, so these weeds need to be plucked with the whole root system. And when I'm doing this, I'm making sure that I don't tear up the actual root system of the tree itself. I'm holding my fingers in place
over the soil level, and then I gently but firmly pluck the weed from the pot. Now, rainwater. Rainwater is great. It is good for the environment and it's very environmental friendly. But there are some things that we need to talk about. One of them being mosquito larvae. Now mosquitoes, they like, you know, humidity and they like water that stands still. They don't want water to run through or pass by. They like pools of water. So I found out that my barrels often get full of mosquito larvae in June, somewhere around late June. And then all of a sudden I will not get any more mosquitoes. So they have this period where they, you know, reproduce and they lay their eggs in the water. And I found a pretty good solution for that. I'm using a pool skimmer, this net mesh that I take away all the debris and the organic matter from the water barrel. We don't want more organic matter into our bonsai mixes, our soil systems, you know.
Long story short, this is a Potentilla fructiosa, and it's a deciduous tree, a bush variety. This tree was rescued last August, last year, from a meadow. It was very dry and on the brink of dying. It was so close. I managed to get a hang of the farmer who owned the meadow, and I talked him into at least letting me try to save it. This was on the end of my vacation because I was working half time back then. And I remember that I had it in a plastic bag for I think almost a week. But I sprayed that bag nice and tightly sealed with water every day. Just sprayed it in a plastic bag. As soon as we came home from the vacation, I repotted it in cat litter and some lava rocks, lava stone. Lo and behold, look at the tree today. It's full of life. And I can tell you, I didn't want to show you this tree too early when we started this year with Bonsai Talk because I was so certain the tree would die on me. But I was wrong. Once again, I was wrong. So the tree, it managed to impress me and it really managed to come back from the dead. This tree was so close to hit the garbage bin this April. I was so close throwing it because it didn't show any sign of life, nothing. I've learned a lesson or two, I can tell you that. This tree has really showed me once again to not give up. Don't give up on bonsai. Keep going, keep growing. Don't stop. Even when it looks really tough, keep on going. The future for this tree, anyhow, will be to reduce the foliage significantly and try to get that Shohin character a lot more. Get some styling in these branches and try to just make the foliage a little bit more denser in this region. It is a bit overgrown right now. But the tree has a cool story and I am very attached to it. This has to be one of the most important trees for the growing season of 2019. And I think I will remember this tree for a long time because of that. And here is another little project that we are doing right now on Bonsai Talk. And this tree has never been featured before on any social media link or any video clip. And this tree is labeled as Shimpaku Juniper, imported. Something unfortunate happened this winter. We lost a lot of foliage on this branch, and that is not good because that's the main branch, that's the first branch. This branch should be the most healthiest branch of all, and it should be dense, you know. And this was one of those things that we couldn't really control. We did everything right and tree just didn't want to cooperate. The tree still has potential to rejuvenate and grow back that foliage, because we have buds here and we have active foliage there. If you look at the other parts of the tree, you can see that the tree have foliage coming, new foliage. There, for example, we have juvenile foliage, we have foliage there, and we have a lot of new foliage there and there. So the tree is healthy. We need to think about how we're gonna approach next winter and dormancy period. Because the tree is so weak, and you can clearly see the foliage is very sparse, the tree is struggling to, you know, get dense again and to fill up the pads, we need to go slowly. We need to treat the tree with respect and dignity and go slowly, approach it slowly. So we're gonna make a slip pot on this tree in spring and just let it grow one other year. I think it can be an exciting tree in some years. So now, when we have seen the more trees that are in the category of being a project and a material, let's take a look at the tree that is a little bit more refined and is starting to get quality as a bonsai. This is the old birch that Bonsai Talk has featured in many times. It was featured the first time ever in our very first Yamadori video. So if you want to see the history of this tree, please check that video out. The wooden box here is literally falling apart. So that needs to be dealt with next spring, next repotting. And I think that next spring, next repotting, this tree will be suitable for a real bonsai pot. It's starting to get that quality now. We always wanted the tree to be broad and to have a big open structure. Many people that style birches, especially silver birches, they will just make all the branches cascade and droop like a weeping style. There is a possibility for dieback. Many of people claim that the only way to grow birch is to have them weeping because of that. People are afraid that they will eventually lose their branches if they're not growing as they do in nature. But we're gonna try to fill out the pads, then we can reconsider bringing that weeping effect of all the leaves. The tree has just been top pruned 2 days ago, so it's a little bit scruffy looking in some pads. The top part of the tree was carved this spring and was bleached with lime sulfur, and we did some carving job up there. The position of the branching is not really there yet. We need to detail wire this tree perhaps once more. This branch, for example, needs to be tilted this position and brought back to fill the space in the back here. And this branch needs to be corrected, and this one, and so on. But the tree is starting to get to a point where it's considered a quality bonsai. The birches are one of my personal favorites. I really like them. I think they're absolutely beautiful. In the wild, birches only get to be around 100, 150 years old. They don't live as long as a pine tree, a conifer, for example. So who knows how old this tree will be.
Take care, and I will see you next time.